In this video, we're going to look at how to do some basic conditional formatting. So conditional formatting will change the format or how the cell looks based on the value within that cell. So the next few tabs, we have some data that looks very similar, and we will apply different conditional formats. So to apply conditional formats, we will go highlight the data that we wish to format. From the Home tab, we'll go to Conditional Formatting. And we already have several predefined methods that we can use here that Microsoft has provided. So let's go ahead and select Highlight Cells. And in this case, we're going to select Greater Than. It automatically puts in 5278, and that is the median. So we're going to change that to we want to highlight anything greater than 8,000. And since we're looking at financial information, higher sales is good. So typically we would not use red, we're going to use green. And I'm just going to select the default. Click OK. And we're trying to get our data to look like the bottom half of the screen. We're going to do this one more time. We're going to select the same data, but this time we also want to make all the lower values red. So once again, I will go to Conditional Formatting, Highlight Cells Rules, and this time I'm going to select Less Than. I want to go ahead and select data less than 2,500. And this time, I'm going to use the default light red fill with dark red text. And there we go. I may have used a little bit of a different value. It should have been 2,000 instead of 2,500 if I wanted to match exactly. But in this case, we have just a couple cells additionally highlighted. In this next one, we're going to use what we call top or bottom, meaning Excel has some defaults set up as either the top 10 items, the bottom 10 items, or by percentage. So once again, let's highlight the same data. From the Home tab, we're going to go Conditional Formatting, and this time we're going to select top bottom. And we can see some simple things. We have above average, below average, the top number of items or percent. So we're going to first select the top percentage in this case. And it automatically defaults to 10, but I want to change it to 15. And I want the top 15% with the highest sales set to green fill with dark text. We're going to set a second conditional format on those cells. I'm going to go to Conditional Formatting, once again to Top Bottom Rules, and this time I'm going to select the bottom 10%, except I am going to change it to 15. I can also use the little bars here. This time I want to make my own custom format. So rather than selecting one of the predestined ones, let's go ahead and go to Custom Format and click OK. In this case, we're going to select a dark red fill, and the font I'm going to make bold, and I'm going to make it white so it appears. And once again, we have the fill red. And there we go. We can kind of see a preview before we commit to it, and I'm going to go ahead and select OK. The next one is actually a great quick visualization to compare the data without having to look at the numbers in more detail. Once again, I'm going to highlight a particular range of data. I'm going to go Conditional Formatting and select Data Bars. And I have several options. I have solid fill. I have some gradient fill, so it just kind of changes color. So pick your favorite. Down below, we're showing a gradient fill of green. I'm going to go ahead and select pink just to be different today. And there you can see. Now, one thing you need to be careful of, you need to make sure all the columns are the same width. Because if one of the columns was a little bit wider, you can distort the data and how it appears to the eye. So if I need to make one column a bit wider because of the title or the data within it, you want to make sure you set all of the columns to be the same width. In this example, we have the same conditional formatting opportunity. We're going to use a data bar, but this time we have negative numbers. So there are some additional settings that we can do for negative numbers. So I'm going to select the data here. I'm going to go to conditional formatting. I'm also going to do data bars. This time I'm going to do a solid fill. And I accidentally clicked on it a little bit too soon, but that's not a problem. What we can do is go to Manage Rules, and we're going to select on it the rule that we want to edit and go ahead and select Edit. Now we can make any changes. So, for example, if I hit that a little too soon, I wanted to hit blue instead, I could do that. I could also make any other changes here. Now, with the bars, we have one more option here is the negative value and axis, and we can select what we want to fill our negative bars. And right now they're showing up as red, but maybe we want to change them to black. We could also change the axis position and the axis color if we wish. So if we want to make the axis color red, that will show up as well. And I'm going to click OK twice, actually three times. And notice it changed our bars to blue and black, and it made a red axis bar. You can barely see it, but it is red in between there. There we go. Maybe that's a little bit better. The next one we're going to do is color scales. So rather than showing just one or two colors, we're going to show a scale of colors. So in this case, a darker the color, the lower the value. The darker the color could be, the higher the value, with lower values being more translucent. So I'm selecting the same data again. I'm going to conditional formatting. And I'm going to select color scales. Now there are several scales that are already defined. And if you hold your mouse over, you can see what they look like. Or we're going to go ahead and define our own. I'm going to go ahead and select a three-color scale. And the lowest values, I'm going to select a purple. I'm going to select keep the midpoint at 50th percentile, but I'm going to change that to white. So I don't want any color to appear for those values in the middle. And the highest value, I'm going to select a deep yellow. Now I could go ahead and select a color from the color wheel. If I happen to know the RGB number, I could go ahead and select that, or the hex number. Otherwise, I could pick any color from here, and we want a brighter yellow. I think a little bit more orange. There we go. And we're pretty close to the school colors of where I'm at. And there's our gradient scale of purple and gold. And the last one we're going to show is icon sets. So these let us put small icons in each cell, helping to give us a visual of what the information is doing. So once again, we're going to go to conditional formatting, and this time icon sets. I'm going to select the one that if I hold the mouse over, it says three triangles, even though it is actually two triangles and a hyphen. So I'm going to go ahead and select that. And that looks good, but maybe that's a little too busy, so we want to go ahead and edit that. So I'm going to go once again to Manage Rules. I will select the one, since we only have one conditional formatting rule, I'm going to select that one. And I'm going to go to Edit Rule. What I want to do is change this middle to no icon, and I'm going to go ahead and change this to 70% and 30%, and click OK. Let's say you come back to this worksheet and you're unsure of where your conditional formatting is located. What you can do is go to your Find and Select, and select conditional formatting. That will highlight cells that have conditional formatting. Also, if you've changed your mind and you don't want to have any conditional formatting, you can go to conditional formatting, clear rules, and you can clear them from the entire sheet or from the selected cells. In this case, I'm going to do it from the entire sheet. Well, that wraps up some of the basics of conditional formatting. Join me for another video on how to use functions and some more detailed conditional formatting applications.